learn how to enter the matrix in After Effects. I'll be showing you how to create that classic matrix look, as well as some other really cool looks using the same technique. I found this stock footage online that I think is going to be perfect for this effect. I have it all set up in After Effects, and the first thing I'm going to do is create a new solid by hitting Control Y, and let's call this Matrix Rain. From here, I can add a fractal noise effect to that new solid. I want to create the look of falling digital rain, so I want some super high contrast, little sparkling fractal noise. I can do this by bumping up my contrast to 500, decreasing my brightness to something like, let's say, negative 175. I can come into my transform and let's bring the size down. Around 20 looks good. And I can change my complexity to something like 3. Now I've got these white dots here that I want to animate down like rain is falling. So on my first frame, I can hit the stopwatch for the offset turbulence, navigate to the last frame in my composition, and let's just drag this down. And if I play it back, we can see we have some falling rain. I can always go back and change the speed of this if I'd like to, but for now, we're gonna stick with this. Now, it doesn't feel very alive. It feels very static and very stiff. I'm gonna add an expression to the evolution to just change things up a little bit. I'm going to alt-click the stopwatch on evolution and type time asterisk 150. And now if I play it back, we can see there's a little bit of motion in our noise. I need to get rid of this black background, but I need to preserve the opacity of these white spots here. One very easy way to do that is to just unmult it. I'm going to use Crate's Unmult, which is a free plugin. It's available in the LaForge suite, and I will be using a number of free plugins in this suite to create the matrix effect, so I suggest you install it. These plugins are absolutely awesome, and they are going to power up your workflow. There is a new native unmult solution in After Effects, which you can use as well, but I will be using Crate's Unmult. The effects are the same. I'll drag that unmult effect onto my noise layer, and as we can see, that just gets rid of the black background. From here, I will add my second free effect, which is Crate's Long Shadow, and I'll drag and drop that onto my solid layer. I'm going to shrink down the length, let's say to 150, and I'll change my direction to be vertical, so 0, 0. And then I want to enable shadow decay, so I'll check this little checkbox here, and I can increase the decay maybe to 80. Let's actually increase the length. I'll go to 250. Next, I'll add the fill effect, and let's change this from a red to a white. And then I'll add a curves effect to my footage. This shot looks pretty good, but there's not enough contrast, so I'm going to just increase the contrast with an S-curve, and I can always go back and mess with this curves effect later on. The more contrast there is in your shot, the more that matrix look is going to pop. Then I can select both my solid layer and my footage, right-click and pre-compose these together, and I'll just call this ASCII driver. And then I'll be adding my third free plugin from the LaForge suite, which is the ASCII plugin. Here I can see Crate's ASCII, and I'll just drag and drop that onto my pre-comp, and we can already see the effect taking shape. Let's toggle down these plugin presets and let's just select matrix. And that looks pretty cool, but that's not the exact effect we are going for, so hang in there. I'm going to toggle down the color here, and let's change the color from green to a white. We'll actually be adding in the green color later on using a different effect. Now, if you don't like the binary ones and zeros, if you toggle down the character option, you'll see that there's a number of different character choices to choose from. I'll actually select the Japanese character for now, and I can play with things like the random shuffle amount and the random speed amount. The next thing I need to do is generate a depth pass. You can do this over at something like Hugging Face. There's various plugins that allow you to do it. There's a number of these machine learning solutions out there that can generate high quality depth passes with a footage input. This is the depth pass that I ended up with. I'll drag it underneath my pre-comp and let's disable the visibility of my depth pass layer. Then I can select my pre-comp again and let's add a gradient wipe effect. I had to scale up my depth shot to match the composition, so I'm going to just right-click on it and pre-compose it. Select Move All Attributes into the new composition, and then I can select my ASCII driver pre-comp again and find that gradient wipe where I have my ASCII plugin applied. Then under my gradient wipe effect, I could change the gradient layer to that depth pre-comp. If I increase the transition completeness, you'll see the effect kind of taking shape. I'll bring this up until I could just see the front of her face, and then I can increase the softness. Maybe we'll bring down the transition completeness a little bit. Now where we see all this, why we actually want to be seeing black. So I'm going to add a solid composite effect and change the color from white to black. And now you can see we have a little bit of that depth fall off where the closer parts of her face are a lot brighter and the further away parts are a bit darker, giving it that more three-dimensional look. I'll add a levels effect, and this will just let me play with the contrast a little bit more so I can fine-tune things. Next, I'm going to create a new adjustment layer. And from here, you can add something like a curves effect. And let's change our channel to be green. And we can start bringing in those matrixy colors if we'd like. But I'm going to actually be using a different plugin. Now, this one is pro, so you don't have to do it this way. But I'm going to be using one of my favorite plugins, which is Crate's Easy Glow. And I'll apply that to this adjustment layer. One of the nice things about this plugin is that it has some really good color controls as well as the glow effect. I'll check linear workflow. I am working in 32 bits per channel here. Let's toggle down the input and mess with the threshold inputs a little bit. I'm going to increase this tint strength from 0 to 100. And we can see that brings in the blue color we currently have selected. But of course, we're going with a matrix look, so I'm going to change this to a green. And let's bump up the intensity of the glow a little bit more. Now, I don't want this background to be pure black. I want a little bit of that matrixy rain. So I'll double click and go back into my ASCII driver pre-comp. Select this matrix rain layer, copy it, come over to my main comp and paste it in. Then I'll take the Crate's ASCII plugin that is applied to the ASCII driver pre-comp. And let's just copy that and paste it onto our matrix rain. And now I can scale up that matrix rain layer. And I can just do a quick mask to say where I don't want my matrix rain to appear. I'll change this to subtract and maybe give that mask a little bit of a feather. And let's bring the opacity down. And then I'll bring this layer underneath my adjustment layer. And that's how we got this cool matrixy look using After Effects and free plugins from the LaForge suite. Now you don't have to do the matrix. Keep in mind, you can always play with different colors in different character sets to come up with unique looks. If you want to download LaForge or any of the plugins I mentioned, go ahead and check the description below. That's it for today. Make it awesome.